Hello everyone, in this video we are going to solve the last question of exercise 4.2. The question says, a cottage industry produces a certain number of pottery articles in a day. It was observed on a particular day that the cost of production of each article in rupees was 3 more than twice the number of articles produced in that day. If the total cost of production on that day was rupees 90, find the number of articles produced and the cost of each article. First of all, understand what the question says. It says that the cottage industry produces any number of articles, let's say 3. And it says that the cost of production means the money which is spent to produce these three products is basically 3 more than twice the number of articles. Means the cost we have to pay or we have to bear is 3 more than twice the number of articles. So basically it's twice is 6 and plus 3. So the cost must be 9 rupees. And obviously if I have to make 3 articles and the cost per article is rupees 9, so obviously the total cost must be 27. So this should be the answer if the number of articles is 3. But here the answer is 90 and we don't know the number of articles. So let's suppose the number of article that cottage industry produces is X. So clearly the cost of production of each article means the money spent on its production, means manufacturing. So it's basically 3 more than twice the number of article. Clearly the cost must be 3 more than twice of this article. So obviously twice of this is this and 3 more. So this is the cost of production. And same as in this, if the number of item you are producing 3 and the cost per article means on every article you have to pay 9. So obviously on 3 you have to pay 27. And in this case you are producing X articles and you are paying this amount on each article. So on X article the total cost must be X multiplied with 2X plus 3. And we know that the total cost is given as 90 rupees. So this can be equated to 90. Solving it, X multiplied by X is basically 2X squared and X multiplied by 3 is 3X. This can be shifted to this side, so this is minus 90 equals to 0. So this is our quadratic equation for this particular question. Now you can solve it by the factorization method, and this can be solved by splitting the middle term. And in splitting the middle term you have to break this 3 into 2 parts such that their multiplication must be equals to 180. Multiplication must be equals to 180, and because here is negative sign, so their difference must be 3. So you can factorize this 180, difference should be 3. You can factorize this 180 and you have to take two of its factors whose difference is 3. Okay, 2 into 90, 2 into 45, 3 into 15 and 3 into 5 and 5 into 1. So basically these are the factors. Now take any two. If we take this as 1, which is 4 multiplied by this is 9 by multiplied by 5 is 45. So clearly their difference is not equal to 3. Again we take another number. This is 4 into 3 is 12 and this is 5 into 3 15. So clearly this is our required numbers. Multiplication of these two is 180 and their difference is 3. So 2x square and this 3x can be split into 15x minus 12x equals to 90 equals, sorry, minus 90 equals to 0, because 15 minus 12 is 3. Now open the bracket. So this is 2x square plus 15x minus 12x minus 90 equals to 0. You can take common from first two terms. So taking x as common, so because the factors of 5 and 2 are not common, means there is no common factor between 15 and 2, so only x will come out, and so here will be 2x and here will be 15, because from 50x x is taken out, only 50 will remain inside the bracket. Now again you have to take something as common, so that inside the bracket only 2x plus 15 remain inside the bracket. So clearly here is 12 and you have to remain only 2, so clearly 6 can be taken out, because 6 2's are 12. Oh, now if 6 is taken out, only 2x will remain, and 6 into 15 is 90, so only 15 will remain inside the bracket. And again this is minus minus and here it is positive, so you have to take minus 6 as common. Now from these two terms, 2x minus plus 15 can be taken common, and in from first term is this is taken out, only x, and from the second only 6 will remain inside the bracket. Now we know that if the multiplication of these two factors is equal to 0, so the value of these two factors, which is 2x plus 15, must be equal to 0. So the value of 2x must be minus 15, so value of x must be minus 15 upon 2. Because x is basically the number of articles, and the number of articles cannot be negative, so we have must take the second part, which says x minus 6 equals to 0. So the x value of x is 6, so we'll take the value of 6 as value of x as 6, means the number of articles that cottage industry produces on that particular day must be equal to 6, and the cost of production is basically 3 more than twice of this number, so twice of this is 12 and plus 3 is 15, so the cost of per article must be 15 rupees on that particular day. So this is how you can solve this last question. Thank you.